Finscope surveys are conducted every 5 years to assess how the landscape of financial access has changed since the last survey and to measure the extent to which various developments within the financial sector have impacted on levels of financial inclusion throughout the country. Coordinated by the Bank of Zambia, with support from stakeholders and partners, the surveys provide a guide for policymakers, financial service providers, and supporting agencies in their efforts to promote better access to financial services by all Zambians. The first Finscope survey in Zambia was conducted in 2005, while the second one was done in 2009. The 2009 Finscope was followed by the 2015 Finscope survey. The 2015 Finscope survey revealed that financial inclusion was at 59.3% at national level, while rural financial inclusion was at 50%. By 2020, the Finscope survey conducted by Bank of Zambia revealed that national financial inclusion increased from 59.3% in 2015 to 69.4%, while rural financial inclusion increased from 50% in the 2015 Finscope to 56.9% in 2020. According to Finscope 2020 survey findings, the increase of growth is mainly attributed to increased uptake of mobile money, which registered an increase from 14% in 2015 to 58.5% by 2020. The top line findings were released at the Finscope 2020 survey dissemination workshop held on the 17th December 2020 at the Radisson Blue Hotel in Lusaka. The event was organized by Bank of Zambia in partnership with key stakeholders, which included the Rural Finance Expansion Program, RUFEP. The event was officially opened by Bank of Zambia Deputy Governor in charge of administration, Mrs. Reka Muhango.
This year's survey presents an opportunity to evaluate the overall trends in financial inclusion. Further, the survey findings will help address the effectiveness of the financial inclusion initiatives implemented and those that are being implemented towards achieving the target set in the National Financial Inclusion Strategy 2017. These targets include the increasing the level of overall financial inclusion to 80% by 2022 from 59% in 2015. Increasing the level of formal financial inclusion to 70% from 38% in 2015. Increasing the percentage of adults with at least a transactional account to 70% from 36%. And improving delivery channels leveraging on digital financial services. The Bank of Zambia recognizes that inclusive, well-functioning financial system enables access to a broad range of affordable financial services to micro, small, and medium enterprises, as well as households of all income levels and demographics. This in turn contributes to reducing poverty and inequalities by increasing resilience, access to credit, investment, job creation, and productivity. In this regard, financial inclusion is the second pillar of the bank's strategic plan, the 2020 to 2023 Bank of Zambia strategic plan.
Presenting the 2020 Finscope findings, Bank of Zambia Assistant Director for Financial Sector Development, Brenda Mwanza, highlighted that informal financial inclusion declined from 37.9% in 2015 to 32.3% by 2020 as more adults were using formal financial services.
A very interesting find. You find the female population has increased to 2.6% from 51% in the previous survey, while the male population has actually declined to 47.4% from 49%. And of those who were financially included, there was a 13.5 percentage point increase in inclusion for those in the urban population compared to 6.8 percentage point for their rural counterparts, where female inclusion has gone up to 67.9% from 57.4%, while male inclusion continues to be at 71.2% compared to 61.2%.
Ms. Mwanza further disclosed that formal financial inclusion was high in the age group between 26 to 35 years, representing 69.3%, and lowest in the age group of 66 years and above.
When you look at the adult population by age, interestingly enough, you find that the population in the country remains predominantly youth. When you look at the definition of youth, 35 years and below, the population between 16 in our survey to 35 years stands at 63.1% compared to 60.1% in 2015. So the youth population has actually expanded, and it calls for interventions in the financial sector nationally, really targeting this age group, which has a lot of challenges.
Financial health is the ability of individuals to use financial services to manage daily needs, protect themselves from shocks, and help them achieve their main goals. The Finscope 2020 top-line findings included baseline findings on financial health and financial literacy, presented by Mr. Floyd Mwanza, the Analytics Director at Financial Sector Deepening Zambia, FSDZ.
When we compare the adult population in the urban setup and the rural setup, what the survey found out is that in the urban setup, we have a higher proportion of the adult population who are financially healthy. Then to talk about the male-female divide, it was just a slight difference. Because when we just focus on the male category, we found that it is about 14.2% who are financially healthy. And then when we talk about the female category, so we have about 13%. So the difference there was not that much. The male population was leading.
Financial literacy refers to awareness and knowledge of key financial concepts required for managing personal finances. The survey findings indicate that the urban population had high financial literacy with a percentage of 31.9% compared to the rural population with 16.2%.
Found out from the surveys that overall we have about 24% of the adult population who can be considered to be financially literate. And then to separate the two in terms of the rural-urban divide, so clearly we are able to see that the proportion of the adult population from the urban setup, they are much more financially literate, because there we are looking at a figure of around, at a proportion of around 32% as compared to the rural setup.
Further, the findings reveal that males were more financially literate than the females, while the level of financial literacy increases with education levels. Official population statistics are key in determining the levels of financial inclusion in the country. Survey methodologies in terms of sampling will require official population estimates in the absence of the 2020 census statistics. As such, the Zambia Statistics Agency becomes an important stakeholder in the 2020 Finscope survey.
The only thing we project is the population. So I think I will just encourage you population numbers. That's if we start projecting, we'll stop collecting data. So we collect empirical data. So projection is for you researchers, except for the census numbers.
During the dissemination workshop, a panel discussion on the theme, sustaining growth in financial inclusion, what needs to be done, discussed on the way forward. The panel discussion was moderated by Bank of Zambia's financial sector development specialist, Mrs. Kabinda Kawesha. Opening the discussion on the question of what needs to be done, RUFE program coordinator Michael Mbulo said more sensitizations were needed to convince rural people on the reality of mobile money to increase uptake. According to the 2020 Finscope findings, the key driver to the increase in financial inclusion is the growth of mobile money, which needs to be sustained. Mr. Mbulo said RUFEP was working with implementing partners such as World Vision, Atlas Mara, Finca, Kasama Christian Community Care, KCC, to promote digitization of savings groups and uptake of mobile money. He said, digitizing savings groups through use of mobile money is much safer, as treasurers do not need to put money in the box, but use their mobile phones to save, which is much efficient.
Taking into account the rural finance policy and strategy, and I think your experience in what is happening in the provincial financial services, what do you think can be done to reduce the financial inclusion gap between the urban and rural areas, and also just raise the number of people who are financially included and have access to financial services in rural areas?
The Rural Finance Expansion Program has been working with various players to intervene at the space of ensuring that there is an increase in the provision of financial services to rural areas. And one of the key things in the rural areas is having sustainable power and to be able to actually charge mobile phones, which are then used to engage in mobile money transactions. So RUFEP has been working with solar energy companies that have are providing services that are called pay as you go. So the these solar energy companies are able to sell the solar energy products to communities in the rural areas, and the rural colleagues in the rural areas are able to pay in small bits in a sort of a leasing fashion. Now RUFEP is interested in that. Not only does it provide the power to charge the phone, but also in terms of the way the repayment of that particular loan is done. It is done through mobile money. So you use your phone to be able to pay back through different agents that are existing in the rural areas. RUFEP is also working with savings groups, basically supporting the savings groups to digitize their transactions. As you know, savings groups have a tradition of meeting periodically, monthly or weekly. At that meeting, each member of a savings group is able to save money and also receive a loan. When they save money, that money is put in a savings box. So what RUFEP has been doing is to help them to digitize. So when they digitize, there is no physical cash that is actually put in the box, but money, the transactions are done through the mobile phone. So you deposit your monies with an agent. At a meeting, you just press different numbers, and the money moves from your mobile phone into either a bank. So that way, we're also encouraging the usage of mobile money. And it basically looks at achieving two things. One, the money is safe, that there's no physical cash that is exchanging.
Financial Sector Deepening Zambia Chief Executive Officer Betty Wilkinson said digitization of savings groups is much safer and helps in promoting cashless transactions, as touching money is the biggest risk in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic. She said FSDZ was working with chiefs to share information on COVID-19 and sensitizing communities on health requirements, such as washing their hands through various media platforms.
So we spent a lot of time talking to savings groups about, can you, you know, help you to get soap and water so you're washing your hands, help you to wear masks, help you to count money and then wash your hands, or count it with gloves as frequently as being done. And then we also had engagement with the chiefs in Liverpool province, who decided that they wanted to share this information throughout the province. So they spoke on the radio, they spoke on the television, they put out posters to make sure that people were well informed in this area. And I think that it's important to recognize that we are seeing less meetings. We're seeing once a month rather than once a week. We're seeing more digitization as people realize that that's safer. We're also seeing some savings groups cashed out early because they said, we really don't want to continue this during the pandemic. And some people who were running savings groups lost their business, lost their jobs, and couldn't repay their loans. And so that took some working out with their groups and how do we handle these circumstances. The restrictions on movement has affected everyone, not least the savings groups. So people who are used to traveling up and down the road to sell tomatoes can no longer run up and down the road, and that affects their businesses, their income, and their circumstances at home. Some savings groups had a higher demand for loans. Everybody needed money, and savings groups was where they were used to going and getting it, and helping them with smoothing their consumption expenditure. And I think what was very interesting for us was that the willingness of savings groups to adapt.
German Savings Bank Foundation for International Cooperation representative Reinhold Honley said while the findings of the Finscope 2020 were critical, there was need to increase rural financial inclusion. Mr. Honley called for the need to harmonize the level of effort by all stakeholders, as more needs to be done to increase financial inclusion in Zambia.
Taking into consideration that Zambians did not have access to financial education during their formative years, the lesson now is that the strategy will need to be reviewed. Zambia does have extremely exemplary leadership in financial education. All that we need to do is now to focus on is to harmonize the efforts of financial education amongst the stakeholders, that we work more together, that we inform each other, and that we know what can be done.
The National Financial Inclusion Strategy 2017 to 2022 under the Minister of Finance targets to increase national financial inclusion to 80% and rural financial inclusion to 75% by 2022.
The aim of the Finscope survey is to provide credible financial sector information in terms of market opportunities, challenges, financial services and products that are being offered and the challenges they're facing, to allow for financial service providers to widen and deepen their reach in providing a broad range of their services and products to the Zambian citizens.
The findings of the Finscope 2020 survey are a wake-up call for all stakeholders and actors in the financial sector on whether the target of 80% national financial inclusion will be achieved by 2022.